The U.S. bishops elect a new president in a historic vote. Los Angeles Archbishop Jose Gomez moves up from vice president to take the reins and become their first Latino to hold the top position. We'll talk with him in a few minutes. But first, correspondent Jason Calvi takes us to Baltimore as the bishops debate what advice they should give Catholic voters for 2020.
As Americans jump into a presidential election year, the U.S. bishops debate a letter to voters.
It is not Catholic teaching that abortion is the preeminent issue that we face as a world in Catholic social teaching.
San Diego Bishop Robert McElroy challenges this line from the bishop's letter. The threat of abortion remains our preeminent priority because it directly attacks life itself. At the same time, we cannot dismiss or ignore other serious threats to human life and dignity, such as racism, the environmental crisis, poverty, and the death penalty.
I think it has been very clearly the articulated opinion of the Bishops' Conference for many years that pro-life is still the preeminent issue. It doesn't mean the others aren't equal in dignity.
Obviously, the right to life is essential, because if there is no life, there is no need for anything else.
And that's who the bishops pick as their next president.
Archbishop Jose Gomez, with 176, is elected the new president.
The Archbishop of Los Angeles. Gomez was ordained a priest of the Catholic group Opus Dei, and he's a Mexican immigrant.
I think it is a special blessing for the Latino community.
The bishops followed custom, promoting sitting Vice President Gomez to president.
Voting is open. Please vote now.
The real election question, who would the bishops pick for VP?
151 votes. Archbishop Alan Vigneron is elected Vice President.
Detroit Archbishop Alan Vigneron. He's a Michigan native who taught philosophy and led a seminary. The bishops also pick leaders of several committees.
Oh my goodness.
How do the bishops break the tie? The older of the two bishops takes the prize.
We also learned more about the Vatican investigation into former Cardinal Theodore McCarrick. Cardinal Sean O'Malley of Boston says the Vatican put together a hefty document which will be presented to Pope Francis, and he expects a report will be released soon. Here in Baltimore, Jason Calvi, EWTN News Nightly.